Howdy folks, this is Checkers back again with another episode of our hopefully still calm XCOM 2 Let's Play, this time with episode 25, I believe, and we have something new here. Shen's Gift, the DLC, has dropped, and we have the ability to enable Shen's Last Gift. Gameplay: Shen's Last Gift unlocks a new XCOM soldier class. Do you want to enable the Shen's Last Gift gameplay content for this campaign? The full narrative context of Shen's Last Gift, including an exciting new story mission, can be experienced by starting a new campaign, but we will fold it right on into ours, and then maybe someday we'll go back and see the new stuff. For now, though, let's check on our soldiers. We were a little battered, but hopefully not too badly, all things considered. Sentinel and Taya are out for 7, and we still have some research we want to get done, and what do we have here? Commander, after our recent success, members of the Resistance in New Arctic have brought us reports of activity that we may want to investigate, and those are supplies, and that is awesome. But as I recall, we are working our way to the east coast of the United States so that we can try and take out this avatar structure. So, all that being said, and as much as I need the supplies, I think we need to head back and once again try and hope for some healing before they hit us again. I would honestly really like just one episode where we got the research in. Not that I don't want to fight the aliens, I just want to get all that research in. Okay, make with the fast healing. Alien debris cleared. A new room is now available for constructing a facility. Kim Gibson is now available. Supplies looted 83. Awesome. Okay, so Shadow Chamber is important and all, although we don't have power for that. Let's head back out to the Avenger and see what we need. Our contacts. Resistance comms. We could try and upgrade, but again, we don't have any power. So right now, it looks like what we may need more than anything is power. Although, if we put Kim in here, we could boost our power by 5. And if we came over here and were to upgrade, we'd only get 1 additional control station, which means we'd only get, I think, 1 additional contact. So now, if we were to build Resistance comms,
communications facility construction initiated.
It would take 16 days, but we would at least have a chance at getting to the eastern United States.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
All right, let's see these.
Commander, we still have the body of the recovered alien test subject in storage. I can begin an autopsy at any time. It could lead to critical breakthroughs in our own research and scientific development.
Uh-huh. You're standing between us and the armor, dude. All right, research report, powered armor, codename Goliath, new item available, Warden armor, new proving ground project available, Wraith suit, new proving ground project available, War suit. From what we've seen of the aliens' activities and their lack of regard for human life, preserving those of us that are still around has to become a task of equal importance to eliminating the alien threat itself. The success of this entire undertaking hinges on our ability to keep our soldiers healthy and ready for battle at a moment's notice. In working towards that aim, our latest armor prototype utilizes more of the alien alloys than any we've previously assembled, and as expected, the durability and potential for damage mitigation is extremely impressive. Initial trials show the armor to be capable of withstanding a direct hit from focused plasma at 5 meters, enough so to increase survivability by a substantial margin. I plan on advising the senior staff not to inform the troops of any perceived toughness associated with a suit. I would hate for our forces to grow reliant on it despite our best intentions, El Shen. Continue. All right, Warden Armor. Our new mastery of the aliens' Illyrium technology has led us to the ultimate in battle armor, the Warden Armor. Illyrium-powered armor provides unprecedented survivability and versatility in the battle against increasingly powerful alien enemies, except Warsuit, by harnessing the power of Illyrium, it may be possible to create a new heavy-powered armor suit capable of generating a defensive force field not unlike those used on the alien craft. Ooh. Wraith Suit. Having seen the aliens manipulating psionic fields for a variety of purposes, we've theorized it may be possible to traverse through the physical confines of our world by developing a psionic field enmeshed in a specially designed light armor suit. Okay, then. Storm Gun, Plasma Lance, Viper King, Autopsy. 5 days, 3 days. Oh, let's see what
Although
this does.
It had been years since I conducted my last autopsy, I found the process returned to me quite naturally. This subject was perhaps less intimidating because of its similarities to varying reptile species found naturally on Earth. Because of extensive cytogenetic modifications to the subject's chromosomes, this could very well be the only male variant in the entire species.
Dr. Tigan, your voice has changed. That was, of course, Dr. Valin from the first new XCOM. Okay, let's go back out
Dr.
to the Avenger.
Shin's constant vigil over my activities is starting to wear thin.
Not almost as thin as your constant complaining about it.
But eventually, she's
okay.
going to have to trust me
Five
if
days.
We're going to achieve our goals.
And supplies. Oh, engineering.
Hey,
let's build that armor. Build items. Armor. What do we need to make Warden armor? 300 supplies! Okay, we have that supply drop.
I should see if any of the troops have been keeping count on alien kills.
And,
Avenger plotting new course.
That truck just became a whole lot more important. You guys can heal in the field. Just lick it. Put some flour on it. Proving ground, experimental armor complete. This stasis vest, this upgraded nanoscale vest, grants an additional 2 health to a soldier, and its built-in medkit, 4, will automatically restore health to wounded soldiers. 1 stasis vest has been added to the inventory. That's pretty awesome. Alrighty. So,
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Viper King, autopsy research complete. Assign new research.
Despite an extensive study of Dr. Valin's research report, I have yet to discover how she came to acquire such an impressive understanding of the processes involved in the editing and manipulation of alien genetic material.
So we have the Viper King autopsy, codename Scorpion, strangely. New Proving Ground project available, Serpent Suit. Having carefully studied what remains of Dr. Valin's personal research reports, I've slowly come to understand the depths of her intellectual curiosity and the degree to which she was consumed by her ambition. By reversing key changes to the Viper's genetic structure, traits intentionally suppressed by the aliens, she created this, Subject Gamma, the Viper King. The idea of a Viper patriarch is in itself intriguing, considering there have been no previous sightings of any male members of the species. Valin theorized this may have been an intentional form of population control, the elders having restricted their subordinate species' ability to breed. Having seen the apparent nesting site created by Gamma and the discovery of egg clutches, none of which were left viable for sampling, I can say with some confidence that the creature did immediately set out to pursue the natural instincts that had long since been restrained through genetic tampering. As of yet, I have no explanation as to how the Viper's venom glands were affected in such a way as to change their form and function so dramatically. Further study will be necessary, but I've promised to allow some of Gamma's remains to be utilized towards a new conceptual armor design, our Tigan. And Serpent Suit, the scales of the Viper King are surprisingly lightweight and flexible, and should provide substantial resistance once reinforced. Okay, so, Plasma Lance or Storm Gun. Let's go with Plasma Lance right now, as I think.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
If we can get a sniper that can use it, it would be really handy. And I don't know how much difference really there is between the Storm Gun / Shotgun or the Plasma Rifle. Okay, so engineering
again.
Let's take a look at the proving ground, because I think it said that this serpent suit had to be researched. We'd take one Illyrium core. We've got 10, 5 alien alloys, we got 126, and 5 Illyrium crystals, we've got 88, and 4 days. So, sure.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
Okay, and then back out to the geoscape we go. And...
Resistance communications facility now operational.
Oh, alrighty. View facility. So, we now have the ability to contact 7 instead of 6. Okay, well, back out to the geoscape we go. We could get to the western United States. It's 5 days to go for these supplies, but boy, it would be nice. Serpent suit complete. Constructed from the lightweight and exceptionally durable scales of the Viper King, the serpent suit greatly enhances our soldiers' reflexes and speed. It also features a grapple mechanism infused with the Viper King's frigid venom, which can be used to pull enemies out of cover and freeze them in place. One serpent suit has been added to the inventory. Serpent armor. An enhanced version of the serpent suit reinforced with Illyrium, this armor maintains all of its predecessor's capabilities while further boosting the survivability, speed, and reflexes of the wearer. Accept. And we try for 2 more days. Cross our fingers.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Plasma Lance. Assign new research. Okay, no commentary. Interesting. Plasma Lance, codename Cressy. New item available, Plasma Lance. With the variety of hostile forces our soldiers are tasked with facing, it seems only logical to provide them with varying alternative means of engaging the enemy, in this case from a much greater range than previously thought possible. By focusing the standard plasma bolt through a series of modulating rings, a single powerful shot capable of devastating targets at extreme range can be produced. As is typically the case, the limitations of our environment preclude us from fully testing bounds of these new plasma-based sniper rifles outside of a simulated environment. Regardless, I'm sure our troops will be eager to find these new limits on their own in the field, and I expect to hear of their exploits for some time to come. Our Tigan. Continue. Aliens' focused beam technology has obvious applications for improving sniper rifles. The Plasma Lance is an unmatched sniper rifle. That, of course, we can't afford to build, but anyway, let's go on to Storm Gun.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology.
And
I'll
back
have a
out.
Report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Please be a lot of supplies.
Strategic resource located.
Oh. An illegally operating transport truck broke down in the waste, and upon seeing the Avenger moving in, the driver ran for cover. However, he quickly returned as our squad approached and asked for help with repairs. After our engineers got the vehicle running again, the driver handed over a few supplies in appreciation. And okay, well, that did not get us enough supplies. Let's hit the black market and
Avenger
see if we can sell enough
course.
To make ourselves some power armor.
Market is open.
Sell inventory. What can we sell? Sectoid corpses. Oh. You know, I normally don't like to do this because we might need them to make something, but, that would get us quite a bit of cash. What else do we have? Oh, you guys. 88, and so that's what, 263. What else? Do we have quite a bit of muton corpse? Let's sell off a couple officers. 100, that puts us at 283. Don't want to sell any of our cool things. 11 stun lancers. Off 3 of those, 112. So we need what? 5. Um, 118. I think that would give us just enough. Yep, to build. Okay. I guess we can see what he's got too. Alien alloys. superior scope, 106 supplies for 35 intel. Well, that would have been something I could have thought of too. All right. Now for right now, let's go with what we've got and go back into the Avenger.
Commander, I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team, but as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment.
Where?
We can have them working on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
I thought they said, we built an extra resistance comms.
We're picking up an unsecured transmission from some clown calling himself Van Dorn. Doesn't sound like the kind of recruit we're looking for.
Okay, actually, not that, but I wonder if we can have our
This coil could provide us with some additional power for the Avenger systems.
Okay.
But we'll need to add some shielding first to protect the crew.
All right, let's do that then. That way we'll get some more power, and then let's get out to the geoscape. Oh, no, wait, I was in here so I could build armor. Can't take me anywhere. Engineering.
Hey, Commander.
Build items, armor, warden armor, squad. We want to go squad before we go
this
individual.
This is our basic power armor frame, providing the durability you'd expect from a giant armored suit.
Okay, I think between episodes I will probably tweak their armor colors a little bit, but not during the middle of the episode. So let's get back out there, back to the geoscape. And off to the western United States to make contact.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Okay, well, hopefully that's already in the works. Making contact.
To establish local regional contact.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
They're really letting me catch up on the research. That's very, very kind of them. All right, assign new research. Stormgun, codenamed Flak. New item available, Stormgun. With the inherent difficulties in trying to forge or manipulate the alien alloys we've recovered from the field, our thought process as to how this material could be used to our advantage turned towards some of the more traditional, rudimentary weapons designs. In containing a small cluster of alloy fragments within a highly energized magnetic field, we found it possible to discharge the cluster using a plasma pulse of varying intensity. The overall design is akin to that of a shotgun, although the result comes more from our inability to form proper projectiles than it does from our desire to generate this particular outcome. Having seen firsthand some of the recent alien forces our troops have been dealing with, I have no doubts they'll still find this new design appealing for its overall stopping power, our Tigan. And Stormgun fires a concentrated set of beam pulses, piercing and melting the target across a substantial surface area. Accept. Advent mech breakdown. Sure, why not?
These robotic units, developed by Advent, seem to be wholly autonomous, capable of targeting and engaging selected units without reliance on external verification. Although it falls on me to work through the initial disassembly, I fully intend on involving Shen in this process, as her knowledge of robotics far outweighs my own.
Okay,
Advent has made steady progress.
I'm sure they have. Thank you for sharing, Dr. Tigan. All right, 3 days to U.S. contact.
Incoming message for you, Commander.
Incoming.
Patching through to your quarters now.
Resistance communication, accept transmission.
Your progress against the aliens over the past month has been significant, Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. We get some more money and stuff. All right, thanks. Okay, let's see. Rapid response. Aliens improve their threat response procedures, guaranteeing reinforcements. Advent stifles the movement of resistance resources, decreasing supplies. That one would kind of suck. 20 intel, let's clear this one up. Aliens increase the strength of their encryption, increasing all intel costs by 100% for a month. In this case, we might actually go for this one. But, and we have some supplies there. We are going to ignore those for the moment, just to get this done.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Advent mech breakdown. Research complete. Assign
Advent
new research.
Advent has legions of these mechanized units out there helping to keep the peace. As far as I can tell, they're fully automated and armed to the teeth.
Advent Mech Breakdown, codename Cardinal. From our initial breakdown, I have to assume the Advent Mech designs was at least in part based on the alien Sectapod, a similar autonomous war machine lacking in biological components. As far as I can tell, the Advent variant was supposed to be less intimidating, more suited for urban pacification or peacekeeping operations conducted in proximity to the civilian crowds. That facade only works because of the carefully disguised weapon systems integrated throughout the machine. I don't think people would react so calmly if they knew about the micro-missile launching system linked to Advent's network, running facial recognition on the crowds at microsecond intervals. El Shen. New item available, Gremlin Mark II. New Proving Ground project available, Blue Screen Protocol. Continue. Gremlin, the Mark II Gremlin is an improved version of the standard Gremlin drone. Not only will it greatly increase the hacking stat of our specialists, but many specialist abilities improve their effectiveness when the Gremlin becomes more advanced. Interesting to know. Blue Screen Protocol. With a number of mechanized units Advent has available to throw at us, developing munitions capable of disabling them should be one of our higher priorities. Tigan suggested we look into disrupting their core operating system, and I agree. It's a good place to start. And a Berserker Autopsy.
This fearsome creature, long referred to as a Berserker, is clearly a genetic relation to the other mutant species we have encountered in the field. For reasons yet unknown, this particular variant is unique in that it is altogether consumed by what can only be described as blind rage, a thirst for combat, unlike any other creature we've encountered.
Okay, and back out to the geoscape we go with a day. We come in peace.
Reading you loud and clear.
Okay, and Vigilio Confido, Commander, the people of the Western United States stand ready to help XCOM however we can. New income, 60
new
supplies.
Regional contacts located.
That's what we're looking for. But, supply drop available, yeah. I think we have time before our next resistance comm is built. Let's get to our supply
Avenger
drop and pick up
course.
our supplies so that we can maybe outfit ourselves with some of the new things we've been researching and would then be able to build. There we go. I was worried this was like an unprecedented amount of time to leave us alone. Commander Advent has discovered one of our resistance havens, and they are targeting innocent civilians in a reprisal strike. View retaliation site. And of course we are going to go help.
Setting course for
off
East
we go
Asia.
Like a herd of Avengers. Right in our own backyard. Okay, everybody has got some cool new armor, which is awesome. And Sentinel is back online. Everybody is back online. We can't really give anyone new weapons. What we could do, though, is give our Rangers... what's she got? 6-8 versus 7-9. Oh, wait. 7-9, 4, 6-8. Yeah, but she's got a lot of bonuses with it. So. And. Well, let's just go then. Let's see. Oh, wait. We do have a stasis vest. Let's give that to Jane. So she's often out in front. And. Anything we can give you? No. Alright, Taya. Alright guys, let's get out there and see if we can't keep some folks alive. Including us.
Sky Ranger, deploy.
Remember that part.
Squad green to deploy.
Begin mission.
One of our contacts in the Resistance says Advent peacekeepers have been spotted conducting a sweep near an outpost in this area. The aliens won't hesitate to kill anyone they find, so we're heading in to protect as many people as we can. Secure the camp and eliminate all hostile forces.
Alrighty, and we are pressing any key to launch.
Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians.
Yeah.
Advent came in hot, and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Okay, looks like there's somebody right here. Who we got up first? Jane. Alright, let's try two-stage movement up front here.
I'm going.
Oh, that was... Okay, well... Iron Maiden.
Sure thing.
Just so we can try and spread some of our line of sight here. Jolt.
No problem, boss.
Oh, don't worry, we'll find some. And who's next? No. Taya. Looks like this way is completely blocked. Looks like that way does go on for a little bit. So Taya, how far can you get this way?
Tired of waiting around!
And then run! It'll be fun. Hoss. Let's keep another heavy weapon set going
right,
in this direction.
I'll go.
And Sentinel, I forgot to give you a med kit again. Can't take me anywhere.
Seems doable.
Alrighty then. So we see one more civilian over there. So we've got one right down there, but I don't think we have anybody who can get there in one turn. Iron Maiden, why don't you come up
heading
here
out
in full cover? Jane, why don't you maybe come over here?
All right, I'll go.
We'll try and split into two teams of three. Because that's going to work well.
These chrysalids seem a little smaller than I remember.
Oh, boy.
Then again, it was never really their size we had to worry about.
Oh, chrysalids. Why did it have to be chrysalids? What do we got here? Taya with two grenades. Can you reach that far? Call Sky Ranger. What? Seriously, where did that come from? Launch frag grenade. Okay, we're sure that's what we're going to do, huh, Taya?
Bombs away!
Okay, well, we knocked off their armor. Hoss, you probably can't... Seriously, why is it doing that? What is this Call Sky Ranger thing? It doesn't even appear to be an option. Okay. Maybe Shen's gift added a few extra gifts that aren't quite as gifty. Let's do this. And although it might be crazy, let's put him on Overwatch just in case he can see these chrysalids. And here we have Sentinel. All right, take your shot. Okay. I'd rather find out what they do if we split them open back home at base than if they, you know, actually come up and do whatever it is they're going to do. Jolt. Jolt, jolt, jolt. All right, I'm going to put Jolt on Overwatch too, just on the off chance he can see something. That's weird. I thought there were more people to assign. But maybe I was wrong.
Like this.
It would be nice if they could miss every once in a while on this kind of stuff.
Got some Advent here.
He's wearing his house scarf. That's right, civilians, flee. Flee for your lives. Oh boy, more bugs. Sir, is this going to be a stand-up fight, or is this just going to be another bug hunt? Uh-oh. Hey. Thank you. Why didn't you get to do that first? Oh, boy. She was poisoned. Hey, but she's got that cool armor that can heal her, hopefully. God's praise. I can't tell if 5 was enough to kill it, though. Yes, it was. Way to go, Hoss.
Okay, so I got one.
Way to go, Hoss. Okay. Jane. And Jane's, it looks like Jane's armor did heal her, I think. Oh, boy. Alright, you know what we're gonna do? Go a little crazy here. Let's make absolutely sure we are in range. And run over here.
Get it done! Go on, get out of here!
Is her armor glowing? There's something different about her look. Come on, don't miss, don't miss. Nice. Wait a minute.
I thought that...
Wasn't it wounded when it came up here? I can't really look back in the, like, the video isn't made yet, but... Huh. What do you got? You got a line on this one. But I'm gonna put you into Overwatch.
Scanning.
Just to be safe. We have enough folks over here, I think, to deal with this. Hoss. Sentinel. You got 100% chance on this one? Fire.
That armor's tough!
Oh yeah, armor. Alright, well... Taya, why can't you see that one? I actually don't know the answer to that, but...
Here I come!
Let's maybe move her around the corner. And then maybe she will actually see this one. Good night.
Whew, you see that?
Yeah. Okay, Hoss. 88% chance, huh? Why don't we up that a little bit?
I hope it's worth it.
94. If you would be so kind, please, sir. Okay, she's glowing gold too. It looks like it might be the poison effect that we're seeing.
There you go. Weapons burning ammo fast!
So, Iron Maiden. What is this? What is this? Okay, this is a little crazy, but let's do it. I'm pretty sure in the old one, if they ran through their zone like that, they'd run away. Hey, he's stunned! That is awesome. Okay, I don't want to do restoration yet, but I think we want to heal. Let's do Iron Maiden first and get the poison off her.
Gremlin, get on the heels!
Because Jane's got her armor that will heal her. I know Claudia's out in the middle of nowhere, just hanging in the breeze there. And what I did didn't help her much. But... maybe... I'm gonna have to put him on Overwatch. It's the best I've got.
Oh, hit.
Yeah. Yeah. Next round is your turn.
Damn it.
Of course. And he's gonna fire at Claudia.
Not sure I can make it!
5. You're actually probably okay. Okay, Jane, plus 2. So, we want... No, I want Jolt. Gremlin heal on Jane. I know she doesn't need that much health.
Go,
I just want to get
out
the poison off her. Okay. I wonder if the suit did it, because I didn't see a poison removed kind of statement. Okay, and unfortunately that's gonna... Well, you know, his Overwatch up here is useless, so let's move him up to here.
I'm going.
And then, Taya, let's get you down here.
Finally!
You guys move up to backup Jane. And Overwatch, please.
Come get some.
Hoss. Why don't you come up here, my friend?
I'm going!
And take a shot at the dude behind the tree. Okay, well...
Missed the target! Weapons empty,
Sentinel.
Can't engage!
Let's get you down here.
No problem, boss.
Oh, that's right. You can go into Overwatch even after going into your second move. So let's get you up here. And Iron Maiden, I want you to first come over here.
On my way. You're safe. Now
get that
moving.
One out. Now I want you to come over here and try and kill this one. Nicely done. Okay, and our officer should still be stunned for one turn. Jane, what have you got? Nothing super pretty. Although there are a lot of people clustered there. We can still have those shapeshifters, I imagine. I hope right here is out of the fire. Oh, what have you got? 25% shot? No, let's go Overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
Moving to Overwatch.
Okay, right on Sentinel. Good name. Oh, he's not stunned anymore? I thought he would stay stunned through this turn. Maybe he did, but it was saying that next turn he won't.
No!
We're losing civilians left and right,
yeah,
Commander.
Yeah, thank
we
you, Captain Obvious.
We need to get these people out of here.
You know what you could do is come down and try and get them while we're doing this stuff. But no. Oh.
I need a med kit here!
Alright. You're next, Sunshine. Sorry, Claudia. Can't take me anywhere. Okay. Jane. Hopefully this is gonna work out for us.
You're good to go! Move!
And hopefully this is not one of those shapeshifters. Oh, hey, guess what it is? A shapeshifter! Jane, if you would be so kind as to try and slice and dice him with your sword, please. Oh boy. Okay, well, Sentinel. Okay, what have we got here? Oh, you're out of ammo. Reload, please. What have you got a shot on? Take it.
It's killing time!
We can hope. Nicely done. Okay. And
one down, thousands to go.
Yep. Okay, game. Oh, nice. Very nice. Okay, Overwatch then.
I'm on it.
Taya, I want you to move up, but after Sentinel moves up. Sentinel, I want you. Well, what have you got on this guy right now? 79% chance. Okay, move up a little bit.
I can handle that.
84, take it. Go critical. 8 damage. Okay, Taya, it's going to be up to you now. Come on up here. We're doing 74% chance, and please don't miss, Taya. Jane's counting on you. Nicely done. Nicely done, Taya. Okay.
How many is that now?
Oh, I don't know,
weapons,
but it's a good number.
Ammo fast.
Okay, Iron Maiden. It's your turn to hope this isn't a shapeshifter.
Sure, get back to the ship.
Okay, so 4. We need 6 minimum. And 4 is still pretty good. Let's see if we go. Well, let's go to full cover. Let's go half cover.
Absolutely.
I'm thinking she can get into this building. And then Jolt, I need you to Gremlin heal her in a big way.
Gremlin, medical detail.
Okay, and back we go. And then... Well, I don't know that your Overwatch would be of any use to anyone. Let's just move you down
a
little
bit.
I mean, it would be if they could get in range, but I don't think they would get into his range. I don't think there'd be any reason for them to. Like, if he could see that far, it would be awesome. Hey, they missed! That's awesome. You should run. Oh boy, another bug. Oh boy, oh, of course. Hoss. Just burn it to the ground, man. Beautiful! That was beautiful! I don't know, XCOM 2 may not be calm today because it's very positive. Okay. Jane. Hopefully this isn't considered fire.
I'm going. You're safe. Now get moving.
Okay, so Jane has saved 5 so far. Can you actually... Oh, that's as far as you can get. Okay, well then, come up to... Run and gun isn't quite there yet. Well, come up to full cover over here.
Have your forces sighted.
Yeah. We knew they were there. Maybe they'll focus on us, though, and we can try and take some heat off the civilians. Okay, now, Taya. This is as far as you can get, but let's do that, and Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Okay, Hoss. Let's get you down here.
Alright, I'll go!
Even though the whole death from above thing is cool. And then Overwatch.
On Overwatch!
Sentinel. We can move you up much further. And let's do that.
Got it, moving!
Okay, and now Iron Maiden. Whew. If I send her in through there, she's a sitting duck for these people. Even with run and gun. There is no pretty place to do this. But let's use up run and gun.
Move into fire position.
And put you right here.
On the move.
And if anybody at least runs past
Get
that window.
Here.
So we got 5 of 6. 6 of 6.
We've secured a civilian contact.
So on the plus side, at least we succeed.
Moving to Overwatch.
Okay, Jolt. Let's get you up somewhere where you can actually do some Overwatch, because...
Whatever you say.
You're really very good at it. Okay, and then Overwatch.
Please. On Overwatch. Got it covered.
And there goes Sentinel dropping into his automatic Overwatch. And there's our shield bearer bearing his shields. Oh well. It happens. Nice shot. Well, we got the shield down anyway.
Oh, man. Get it together.
Okay, what do you got? Let's take a look at the building from this perspective and really hope this isn't
clear?
A shapeshifter.
Why are you just standing around? Go!
57 and a 53. 57, huh? Take your shot, Jane. Oh, well, whatever that was over there, it deserved it too, I'm sure. Okay, and let's go back to our regularly scheduled view so I don't get too confused. And let's bring Taya up here.
Tired of waiting around.
And have her go into Overwatch.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Hoss, let's get you up here.
I hope it's worth it.
He's got a 73% chance on a fully exposed target. And he did that. Nicely done, sir.
Okay, so I got one.
Yes, you did. Okay, Sentinel. You actually... You could actually run all the way in here, but I'm not sure where that one is. So, let's get you into full cover by the window here.
Seems doable.
Well, that's probably better than what his Overwatch shot would be, so take it. No good.
Negative damage!
Yep, notice that. Oh, hate when that happens. Okay, well... She'd be exposed if she did it. But she can get to here.
Not a problem.
Tell me you got a shot. I wonder if this would harm the civilian above. Well, let's put her into Overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
Jolt.
Let's move him up.
And Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
Yeah. I wonder if these are our last three. Or if there's probably at least one more shapeshifter hiding around in here.
Oh, we need armor. All right, that one hurt.
And on the plus side, we got good armor. Oh, we didn't get good enough armor for that. All right, let's give you guys something else to think about. Okay, and Taya. Taya, come over here if you would, please. Tell me you can see somebody. Take your shot. Okay, well, not pretty.
Enemy is still up.
Okay.
I'm out of firepower over here.
Hoss, you need to reload. Okay, I guess... No, he's outside your range, so Overwatch, please.
Overwatch!
Sentinel, hang on for just a moment, if you'd be so kind. Well, you need to reload no matter what. We're not giving up on you, though. Who's out in the open? 76. Come on, Claudia. Oh. Everybody's missing on him.
Shot failed to connect.
Yeah, I noticed. It's okay.
Toss me some ammo.
Not quite yet. Jolt. I need Gremlin heal on Sentinel.
Heal him up.
Okay. And now Overwatch is the best you've got. Sentinel.
Gonna
put him in full cover there. But he'll get his Overwatch. Oh. Was really hoping Jane would get a swing at him as he ran.
Can't take much more of this.
Sorry, Jane. Needed to take some of the heat off Sentinel. Unfortunately, that means you picked it up.
I'm under fire! Watch
the
flanks!
Yep. Okay. Okay, we removed his shield.
Target, minimal damage.
We got his shield down. That's what we really wanted. Okay, Taya, reload. Which means, of course, well...
Let's rock!
Let's get her up to here at least.
Here I come!
Hoss, let's get you up to here.
I'm going!
Nothing, huh? Okay, Overwatch.
Move me to Overwatch!
Sentinel. Sentinel. Maybe here.
I'm going.
That was a curious route to take. But you go, Sentinel. If you would be so kind, please, sir.
Deflection!
Okay, Iron Maiden.
Heading out.
Take your 58% shot, please. Nicely done. Finally get him down. That means Jane is no longer exposed by standing right next to someone.
My weapon's spent.
Okay, Jolt. Oh, where can we get you? Let's try and get you into there, even though that's not going to put you into a position for Overwatch. Come on, guys, we can do this. Oh. Oh, he is hit bad. Okay, well. Maybe hit bad, but he's alive. And that's really what we can ask for out of this. Jane, be so kind, please. Okay. And actually, let's go to Jolt, and we are out of heals, but we have this. So,
big heal coming up.
Let's roll. It's not perfect, but it's going to give everybody a little bit of extra health, mostly him. And okay, now let's get to Sentinel. Let's see. Oh, where could we get you where you might actually get a shot? Right here, maybe?
I can handle that.
Can you get a shot on him? Wow. Okay. And then we want Claudia. Let's reload.
Good to go.
Yeah, yeah. And then Claudia, if you'd be so kind.
That's right.
Okay. Now it looks like there probably is another shapeshifter.
All right, I'll go.
But we won't know until the alien turn. And Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Taya, let's get you over to here.
Let's move already.
And Overwatch.
I'm on it.
Hey, guess who it is? Come on, Stay Puffed. We're waiting for you. Get into range.
Not good.
Yeah, very not good. On the plus side, it's our turn. I hope. You know, after he's done, like, calling us out and stuff. Jane? Taya.
Thank you.
Maya for the kill.
You can't handle me. Burning through ammo fast.
Okay, and let's move Hoss up.
What's over there?
No idea. Going Overwatch.
I'm on it.
Sentinel. Reload. Overwatch.
Ready to go. Covering now.
Iron Maiden. Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Jolt. Overwatch.
Overwatch.
Nope, we still got something else in here. That's right, come through the window. Nuts. Okay.
I hope it's worth it. Frag out!
Let's break the cover. Give everybody a shot at this thing. Okay, Taya.
Finally!
79% shot. And again with the kill.
You want some more? Negative! Weapons dry!
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Whew. Okay. Mission type, stop advent retaliation. Civilians rescued, 8 of 13. Turns taken, 11. Enemies killed, 13 of 13. Soldiers wounded, 3. Rating excellent and continue. Okay, successful shot percentage, 72.22. Average damage for attack, 6.07. Sentinel, could you sit back a bit? Thanks. Average enemies killed per turn, 1.18. Average cover bonus, 27.58. Dealt the most damage, Major Taya Boom Boom Mubu. Made the most attacks, Major Johannes Sentinel Smits. Most under fire, Colonel Jane Wildchild Kelly. That's hard to believe. Move the furthest, Colonel Jane Wildchild Kelly. And we are on our way back to base. And our cool new armor, I am positive, kept us alive through that. Sentinel, I'm sure, is very, very, very attached to his armor as it kept him alive with one hit point. Okay. And back to the barn. I really want to know what this is supposed to be. Just this, or... Anyway. Touchdown. And we're going to have some gravely wounded... Sentinel. Jane's pretty battered too. Okay. And still not too shabby. Continue. Artifact. Chrysalid corpse. The extreme toxicity of the chrysalid venom requires individual specimen storage in reinforced caskets, each one of which have been securely padlocked upon the advice of veteran combat staff. And we got 6 of those. 1 Advent Trooper corpse, 2 Advent Officer corpses, 2 Faceless corpses, 1 Advent Stunlancer corpse, and 1 Advent Shieldbearer corpse. Continue. And Chrysalid Autopsy. They may have features resembling a variety of terrestrial insect species, but these creatures are deadlier than anything bred of our world. Their armored exoskeleton is of particular interest and may provide insights towards the creation of an armor suit capable of actively damaging enemy forces as they engage in combat. Continue.
Hello, Commander.
The Resistance in East Asia is grateful for your efforts to repel the aliens' retaliatory strike. With XCOM's ongoing protection, the Resistance will continue to flourish. Monthly supply rewards increased across Asia. Income increased by plus 39 supplies. Continue. Alrighty, folks, that was a long but very fruitful episode. And, well, we'll take a look at all the wounded next time. For now, this has been episode, is it 25? I believe, of our hopefully still calm, if exuberant, XCOM 2 Let's Play. And we will, of course, be back in episode 26. I would like to remind you that I have a Twitter link in the description of the video and on my channel main page. If you're on mobile, it'll be on my channel about page. Also, if you look in the upper right-hand corner, you will see a small letter I with a white circle around it. These are cards and links to other videos that I've made. I would like to thank you for watching. I hope you found the video entertaining and maybe just a little informative. I would like to invite you to subscribe and ask you to please take care.